Peace TV English, the solution for humanity.
Islam is there since time immemorial, since man first set foot on earth.
The way of life acceptable to God Almighty is Islam.
Allah says in the Quran,
we are going to protect the authenticity. This book.
Only one deserves to be glorified is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Islam will trump over all fighters.
The most honorable in the sight of Allah is the most righteous of you.
And that is what Allah says in the Quran.
All who believe and enter Islam wholeheartedly.
He's giving us an opportunity to do a prophet's job and to earn a prophet's reward.
Allahu Akbar.
Our next speaker for the day is Ghazi Chauhan. A confident boy of 11, Ghazi is endowed with remarkable memory and good grasping power, alhamdulillah. He has progressed greatly over time and was awarded for excellence in English language. Ghazi delights in exploring the creation of Allah through Quran and science, and he admires to be a scientist, a blend of both the worlds. Ghazi's inspiration is the book of Allah and the sunnah of his messenger, peace be upon him. Millions memorize the Quran, treasure it in their hearts. Millions read it, but unfortunately, only a few comprehend and understand it, while fewer implement it. Al-Quran has been revealed for a definite purpose. It's time we introspect. Have we really understood the Quran? Ghazi Chauhan on towards understanding the Quran.
All people of the world, can we spare a little justice? Can we spare a little peace?
Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala Rasulillah wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd, fa'audu billahi min ash-shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري وحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. My respected elders and my dear brothers and sisters, I welcome all of you with Islamic greetings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May peace, mercy and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon all of you. The topic of my talk is towards understanding the Quran. Subhanallah, with all the CDs, the tapes, the different sizes of the Quran, the transliterated Quran, and this is nice and beautiful. They get them in nice leather jacket and pocket size, whatever it is good. But more of that is being devoted to preserving the letters of the Quran and not really desperate on the commands of the Quran. What we want is to only learn how to read the Quran properly. Again, that is good. But it seems that that's where we always stop. I started my talk with a verse from the glorious Quran, from Surah Al-Isra, chapter number 17, verse number 9. إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمُ. Indeed, this Quran guides humanity to that which is best. Best in form, best in manner, best in result, best in path. Keeping this in mind, my dear brothers and sisters, let us focus on some of the most valuable lessons learned by understanding one of the earliest passages of the Quran, which will guide us to make the best of people and the best of societies, inshallah. Amongst the very first verse revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we all know that it was Iqra. What was the very next surah that was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Surah Al-Muddassir. When the Prophet ﷺ was returning from the cave of Hira, Angel Jibreel came to him, standing in the horizon. He went back shivering to his wife Khadija radiallahu anha, and he hugged her, covering with a piece of cloth, because he was very scared. And then Allah speaks to him and says in Surah Al-Muddassir, chapter number 74, verse number 1 to 5, Ya ayyuha al-Muddassir, oh, the one wrapped up. And then the four commandments are given to Muhammad ﷺ, that the spirit and mission of Islam revolves around these five verses. It starts saying, Ya ayyuhal muddassir, oh, the one wrapped up. قُمْ فَأَنذِرْ, rise and warn. Actually, the word قُمْ in Arabic is translated using 15 words in English. قُمْ means to get up, it means to erect, it means to rebel, it means to resist. It means not to be satisfied with what is going on. It means to start a movement and much more. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the commandment to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قُمْ, get up, rise, erect, rebel, and do not be satisfied with this status. And that is why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was depriving himself from sleep. And then Khadija radiallahu anha used to come and say, Ya Muhammad, Ya Abu al-Qasim, go to sleep. And then Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, the time for sleep has long gone. And now I'm involved in what is known as rebellion, resistance, a movement has taken place. So that is number one. Number two, Allah says, وَرَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ, and your Lord glorify. Only one deserves to be glorified is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the time, the people used to glorify nationalism. They used to glorify the statues. They used to glorify the man-made idols. But in Islam, we are taught Allahu Akbar. Of all that is glorified, Allah is the greatest. And only Allah's name has the right to come at the place of takbir and constant glorification of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nowadays, where movie stars have got their huge big billboards, people want to dress like them, people want to talk like them, people want to be like them. People want to know what do they eat, what do they drink. And you'll see people selling advertisements, use these movie stars, professional athletes, to tell us since we glorify them. But in Islam, we are taught Allahu Akbar. Of all that is glorified, Allah is the greatest. Subhanallah, it is so interesting. They say, of all the statements that's there in the Quran, of all the statements taught to us by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most revolutionary is when you say Allahu Akbar. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَثِيَابَكَ فَطَحِّرْ. In Arabic, the term thawb has two meanings. Thawb either means your outer garment, most of the time, thawb refers to your heart. Or here, it means the heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the commandment to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, cleanse, clean, purify your heart. And this was one of the mission of the Quran. And most of the time we miss this point, that whoever embarks on this mission is expected to have a purer heart, a cleaner heart, a softer heart. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالرُّجْزَ فَهَجُرْ. Rujz are all your sins, all acts of wickedness, evil, devilish acts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَهَجُرْ. So remain away from it. You cannot be a part of any filth, any immorality. A Muslim cannot and should not be a part of it. And these were the four commandments which were given to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For any movement to be a beneficial one, for any movement to have its fruit, you should have these four commandments. And when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came, the people who were living at that time were the Jews, the Christians and the pagans. The Jews used to say, نَحْنُ وَبْنَاهُ اللَّهُ وَعِبَّاهُ. We are the children of God and His favorite. We might be punished, but that will be just for a few days. And we'll be saved simply because of this. The Christians used to say, we believed in our God, the true God, the true Savior, Jesus Christ, peace be upon Him, and we'll not be punished because He died for our sins. The pagans used to say, either we come from this tribe or that tribe, Allah will not punish us because of our position in society. And then Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came in with a statement as mentioned in Surah An-Najm, chapter number 53, verse number 38. And no soul shall carry the burden of another soul. And then further Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Najm chapter 53, verse number 39, وَأَلَّيْسَ لِلْإِنسَانِ إِلَّا مَا سَعَى. That man will only be held responsible for only his deeds and actions. If you really want to be benefited by the Quran, you should start implementing the Quran in your lives. And when Aisha radiallahu anha was asked about the character of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what was the character of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? She answered that the character of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the Quran. Subhanallah, it is so interesting. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was a living Quran. I would like to end my talk with a quotation of a beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as mentioned in Sahih al-Bukhari, volume number 6, hadith number 5027, the book of virtues of the Quran. It is mentioned, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. Best amongst you is the one who learns the Quran and imparts its knowledge to others. May Allah make us from those who not only recite the Quran by the tongues, but also implement it by the limbs. Ameen. Wa akhiru da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Jazakallah, Brother Ghazi, for your excellent presentation. Our next speaker for the day is Arsh Zagade. Arsh has excellent memorizing skills and is an enthusiastic learner. Born on 1st October 1996, Arsh is a grade 11 student, 17 years of age. He's obedient, cheerful, kind and helpful. His noteworthy achievements include the complete memorization of the Glorious Quran at the young age of 12. He also understands Arabic as a language, alhamdulillah. He has retained the English Public Speaking Certificate of Excellence in his class for the last 4 years. He has also received the Certificate of Excellence in Swimming for 4 consecutive years. Besides these, he has received several certificates for poetry, storytelling, etc. right from Standard Nursery. Arsh is an ardent football player, enjoys basketball, and his hobbies include excelling in martial arts and reciting the Glorious Quran. When asked, what is the problem of the present generation youth? He promptly replies, living life king size and the drive to instant gratification leading to moral turpitude and the ruin of youth. The best thing in life, he reassures, is when people accept Islam. MashaAllah. He aims to be a da'i and wants to dedicate his life to spreading the message of Islam and seek Allah's pleasure. Whether it is spending wealth, fasting, or doing any other ibadah, for everything in Islam, it's balance that is recommended in the Quran and Sunnah. Arsh to speak on the justly balanced Ummah.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
Where truth is hidden, misleading quotations create confusion. Where truth is hidden, lack of knowledge and wisdom cause upheaval and commotion. Where truth is hidden, manipulated scriptures and twisted facts emerge. This very hidden truth creates false propaganda, mayhem, chaos, disorder, and turmoil in our lives and the world order. But is there anyone with courage and wisdom? What is the truth? And who has the courage to expose it? Because it's your right to know the truth.
Watch Truth Prevail and Lies Perish in Truth Exposed by Dr. Zakir Naik. Every Sunday to Friday at 9 p.m. and repeat telecast at 7:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV.
Scientific notions in the Glorious Quran are among its endless aspects that can testify for the divine nature of this noble book. These scientific notions are probably the best addressed to the people of our time.
I am Zaghloul Al-Najjar. Please join me in this program to discuss some aspects of the scientific notions in the Glorious Quran.
Created the universe. Appreciate the word-to-word authenticity of scientific notions and proven facts mentioned in the Glorious Quran 1400 years ago in Scientific Notions in the